Welcome to Solving with AWS Solutions, where we explore ready-to-deploy solutions built by AWS. I'm Heather, and today Jason and I are exploring the Generative AI Application Builder on AWS. This solution simplifies application development that can often be complex and time-consuming. It's a web-based interface that seamlessly integrates with AWS services and LangChain to enable third-party connections, which accelerates time to launch.
The Generative AI Application Builder solution helps developers, engineers, and architects get the rapid experimentation and innovation needed for developing applications with easy configuration and scalable deployments.
Let's look at some of the key benefits of Generative AI Application Builder on AWS. You can experiment quickly with multiple configurations of various large language models, prompt engineering, enterprise knowledge bases, and other parameters. Generative AI Application Builder on AWS has pre-built connectors to Amazon Bedrock, and it's included large language models such as Amazon Titan and select third-party LLMs. This solution gives you the flexibility to deploy the model of your choice, as well as the AWS and third-party services you prefer.
Using Lambda functions or LangChain connectors, users are given the choice to connect with a wide variety of third-party models and services, which can support simultaneous experimentation across models to help you understand which one performs best for your specific use case.
Now let's dive into how you can get started with Generative AI Application Builder on AWS yourself. Jason, where do I get started with the solution?
So the best place to get started is the landing page in the solution library. You want to scroll down and you'll see some details about the version, the deployment time, the possible costs, some features and benefits, and also two really important links. One, an implementation guide, which we'll talk about in a minute, and the single click launch an AWS console button, which will deploy directly to your AWS console with one click.
Awesome. And can you tell me what AWS services and products are in this solution?
Yeah, let's look at the architecture. So you can see that there's Kendra, which organizes documents and helps search through all that information for you.
Let's talk about Kendra really quickly, because this is important for an application using the Retrieval Augmented Generation, or RAG, approach. RAG is a technique that takes an organization's enterprise knowledge base or content and bundles it with user requests to the LLM so you get more context-specific responses. Amazon Kendra gives you the Retrieve API that's designed for the RAG use case, so you get that high-accuracy search that sources the most relevant content and documents and maximizes the quality of your RAG output.
There's also DynamoDB, which stores the conversational information, the temporary information. And then we use an open source project called LangChain, which helps connect to all the wide variety of models out there.
And of course, we have our key service, Amazon Bedrock, which gives us our choice of high-performing foundational models we'd like to use. And so if I wanted more information about Generative AI Application Builder before I'm ready to deploy, where would I go?
The best place to start is the implementation guide. So you can click on the implementation guide, and this will give you a bunch of details around your AWS console limitations, the regions where you can deploy it, and also, most importantly, the definitions and the parameters that you can use when you're setting it up.
Can you show me how to deploy this app?
Absolutely. So go back to the landing page and click on the Launch an AWS Console button, and it walks you through a couple clicks in the CloudFormation template, and you're good to go. And you wind up with your administrative screen here. And so after your administrative screen, you just want to deploy a new use case. And this is where you get to make your choices on what you want the app to say and how you want the app to work. So we're just going to give this a quick name and move on here. So from here, you get to choose which large language models you want to connect to power your application.
And which language models can I connect to?
Sure. So you can connect to any large language model out there, but we've built a couple in to make it convenient and fast to get started. We have Anthropic and Hugging Face built in. You can also connect to Amazon Bedrock or Amazon Titan as well.
So how can I tune this to help prevent hallucinations?
Yeah, hallucinations are an interesting problem. You can tune it using the scale from 0 to 1. 1 is super creative, and 0 is super didactic. So depending on what you want out of it, you can adjust it here.
Gotcha.
And then also, we have an option to stream the information instead of bringing it back in a single block.
And why would I choose streaming?
Streaming offers real-time interaction and real-time data response from the large language model, so it makes it feel like more of a conversation instead of just getting a block of data back.
Yeah. So now can we take a look at this now that it's been deployed?
Yeah, let's look at the chatbot that it deploys. So after you deploy this, it gives you a URL and some login information, and it comes up with the chatbot.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty familiar interface, so we can ask it anything we want, like write me a blog to sell shoes. and it'll process that information and it brings it back pretty quickly. And it talks about draft blog post, five sentences, gives you some information. You can also say, please make this longer and specific to dress shoes. Mm-hmm. And it'll take that information and help make the prompts more and more specific and have better content. That's Generative AI Application Builder.
Thanks, Jason. This was great.
You're welcome.
Thanks for joining us on this episode of Solving with AWS Solutions.
You can find this and other solutions in the AWS Solutions Library.
See you next time.